team. And that's what you don't want to do, drop your guard, because DeCloy will come forward at you, as he is now doing. DeCloy coming forward aggressively. And Parker took a tremendous amount of punishment.
With tough Americans like David Bay and James Tillis being brought in at great expense to test Johnny, he duly obliged and kept on winning until he came against former WBA heavyweight champion Mike Weaver and was stopped in the seventh round.
Really happened.
He bust his hand up.
Well, he seemed to be driving into the ploy. And now that a body shot. Was that low? I didn't see it.
Body shot there that goes down low, and Stan Christodoulou allows the box in
under
the boxer.
Under no foul rule, he's giving DeCloy time to recover. It must have been a low blow.
Piece of ice has dropped on the canvas there, is what I can see. And a very strange thing to happen, a bit of ice falling on the canvas.
Okay, time out.
Back on again we go. Certainly Weaver throwing a lot of good body punches into DeCloy. DeCloy's taking another one. Now, what is that?
Now, that's not the way he's going to win this fight, surely. A no foul rule applies here. The referee would have to be really convinced that DeCloy is badly hurt. In fact, he can give him 5 minutes in which to recover if necessary.
Stanley Crestadulu not happy about that. He seems to be hurt somewhere on the line as well.
Is it his arm?
And by the time we took the glove off, you couldn't see his knuckles at all. It was like a cushion.
Johnny came back to stop James Broad, and in a return with Mike Weaver, looked sensational in avenging his only defeat with a devastating second-round knockout.
He doesn't want to go wild. He doesn't want to take the chance of punching himself out, because that's what he did in the first fight in the third round. But meanwhile, Weaver probably is recovering from those punches. Oh, no, he's not. He's not going to get up.
He won't get up.
He's out.
Revenge is sweet for Johnny DeCloy. The count is 10, and Johnny DeCloy has won this fight.
But the next fight with James Pritchard was probably the most controversial one of Johnny's career.
DeCloy in an ever-retreating movement here. Nothing to offer now. He's a beaten man. He takes the left hand that staggers him. He looked hurt for a moment there. Still walking with his hands held low. Pritchard throwing caution to the wind. Doing just as he pleases here almost now. His fitness has carried him through. DeCloy too, I think you can give him full credit. He's a lot fitter than many people think he should be. But he's fit. Two fit heavyweights. They put up a bruising battle. The punchline and the computer heavyweight bout.
The fight is a draw.
Well, it's called a draw. Pritchard throws himself on the canvas in despair. He's actually laughing, and I don't blame him, because how that was scored a draw, well, I'll never know.
I looked at the tape of the fight, and I would have preferred to have lost to Pritchard instead of the match being declared a draw. But I must admit, as I saw things, I'm sure I should have won. I don't like to predict results, but I'm definitely going to win. I must.
In the red corner for this heavyweight 10-round fight, out of Yonkers, New York, weighing in at 212 pounds, with a record of 30 wins, 7 losses and 1 draw, 16 by knockout, out of Yonkers, New York, it's Rinaldo Snipes.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, in the blue corner, weighing in at 213, 19 wins, 17 by knockout, from West Paterson, New Jersey.
referee Dick Bartman calls the two fighters together for final instructions. Ronaldo snipes with some gamesmanship, waiting till the final second to face his opponent as we take a look at the tail of the tape. And there you see the big age difference. They are about the same height at 6'3", 1 pound difference, and a slight reach advantage for Ronaldo, Mr. Snipes. This will be a 10-rounder. That's Johnny Duploy in the blue trunks on the left and Ronaldo Snipes in the white trunks. We are underway. Johnny Duploy under the tutelage of Lou Duva, who just took over the instruction for Johnny Duploy a couple of weeks ago, sent him down to Virginia Beach. He hasn't really had much time to change the style of Johnny Duploy. Lou Duva says there'll be plenty of time for that. Knockouts, only the one loss to Mike Weaver, and he avenged that. And of course, drew with James Pritchard. It was a fight in which Duploy was suffering from the flu and really never should have gone ringside to begin with. Ronaldo Snipes coming off a victory over Terry Armstrong here on Score, an 8-rounder in New York on June 16th. Earlier, he had lost to Roland Norris for the NABF Heavyweight Championship. And the feeling out process now in the first round, we will go 10. This is a non-title fight, but a very important one in the heavyweight division, as a lot of people get their first good look at Johnny Duploy, who's only 23 years old.
He's a right-hand banger, lacking fundamentals, according to Lou Duva. Not good at cutting his man off. But Duva says he can punch hard with the right hand and takes a good punch.
Johnny Duploy used to spar with his idol, Harry Coetzee, in South Africa. Learned a lot from him.
Coetzee, of course, held the heavyweight championship for a short while.
Johnny Duploy now getting the attention of Ronaldo, Mr. Snipes. Snipes in Pittsburgh putting Larry Holmes to the canvas, but later knocked out by Holmes. The only time Ronaldo Snipes has been knocked out in his long career. It spans 10 years, and tonight he faces a young lion in Johnny Duploy.
Throw me that right hand straight sometimes, okay?
Straight, that's what I cut him with.
Yeah, right?
Got it there.
Okay, baby?
Jab, jab, straight right hand. says Hector Rocha.
And there's Lou Duva, trainer of the Olympians, who now has Johnny DePoy in his stable. And it may be a year or so before Lou Duva really brings out the best in Johnny DePoy. He says there's a lot of things he'd like to change, but right now it's just too late because he only began working with him a couple of weeks ago. The only telling blow in the first round was a shot to the face of Johnny DePoy. He shook it off.
Big right hand by Ronaldo that hurt him in that first round. Ronaldo keeps busy with the jab and then looks to bring the right hand over it.
Ronaldo Snipes won his first 22 fights in a row, including victories over Eddie Mustafa Muhammad and Jerry Coetzee. And it wasn't until the loss to Larry Holmes that Ronaldo Snipes suffered his first defeat.
Pursue the Pennant is a baseball fan's dream come true. The Detroit Free Press says Pursue the Pennant makes other games look like.
John Losing, Bill Berger back with you from the Eagles Club in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Our main event of the night, heavyweights, Johnny DePoy, Ronaldo Snipes. You have them split in the first two rounds.
That's right, 19-19 after two rounds, unofficial, of course.
Snipes won the first round. DePoy came back in round two and unloaded some combinations on Mr. Snipes.
He seems to be zeroing in on Snipes.
There was a time when Johnny DePoy was a bit in awe of the American competition. Face it, there's just not much heavyweight talent in the country of South Africa. And when he would meet a big-name opponent like Attilas or a Bey, he was somewhat intimidated. In the ring, he's all business, and we can see an example of that right now. Good concentration by Johnny DePoy. No matter what he does, he's a very good athlete in rugby.
Good right, and doubles it up to the body, sorry.
He always focuses on the job at hand, and that was told to us by his trainer, Rodney Berman. Shot of the chin right there. Ronaldo Snipes has very busy hands, and he goes down for the first time in the night.
No punch, no knockdown.
It was more of
his own momentum carried him.
A matter of Snipes' legs buckling and then rolling to the canvas. Johnny DuPloy fought in Hartford, Connecticut, the first time he'd been to the States, beating Steve Sowski. Now here in Milwaukee, he has Ronaldo Snipes in a spot of trouble. Snipes using the ropes. He's doing well with uppercuts, both hands. Two go inside like that, Phil, you have to think that Snipes gets the best of it because of his strong punches.
That's right. From afar, he gets good leverage, does DuPloy.
Snipes with a shot to the stomach at the end of the round. And a big round of applause for the bout because the two go toe-to-toe. They're on the third round. Into the corner now as we listen to Lou Duva.
You got
to
come back with the left hook. Understand? You got to come back with that left hook now. Okay? What he's doing, see, you're throwing the uppercut and he's turning on you. You got to come back with that left hook. If you throw a right hand, you got to come back with a left hook. Okay? And you can hit him with a straight right hand. But come back with the left hook. Okay?
So Lou Duva, plenty of experience in the ring with Meldrick Taylor and Biggs and Breland and Holyfield. Now taking on Johnny DuPloy.
This guy's hurt out there, baby. Come on, let's go.
And the cut now being worked on by Willie Luck.
Sticking your head up. Put your head down and punch. Come on, you've got to
put his head down when you do.
Let's go.
It's a small cut, but could be telling. It's the first sign of any blood by either fighter. And we get underway with round four. It's a scheduled 10-rounder. And Ronaldo Snipes, who never did get a share of a heavyweight crowd, comes out with a vengeance here in round four with an overhand right that almost takes him to the canvas because of the momentum. Snipes spoken here at the start of round four. Some counter punching by Johnny DuPloy. And DuPloy pulls his head in there into the chest of his brother Snipes.
Blood from the mouth of Ronaldo Snipes and a good right hand. Big left hook by Johnny DuPloy.
Here comes Johnny DuPloy. He sees the blood on the lip of Ronaldo Snipes. 13 of Johnny DuPloy's 21 fights have been by knockout in 5 rounds or less. We are in the 4th round, but now here comes Ronaldo Snipes.
Working all night for Johnny DuPloy.
What does DuPloy try to do when he sticks his head into the net like that of Ronaldo Snipes?
I think he's just trying to get leverage for his uppercut.
Almost like a linebacker making a tackle on a small running back. DuPloy will stick his head right in there and tie up Ronaldo Snipes. Some excellent camera work now from our crew as you get a sense of this fight. These two heavyweights exchanging a lot of leather now in round four. And the clock is ticking on Ronaldo Snipes as Johnny DuPloy lashing out with everything in his arsenal. Stopped after that last flurry because Snipes was just standing there.
It's getting to be a war here.
It's a war already with less than 30 to go in round four. And the crowd now on its feet here at the Eagles Club in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, as high caliber boxing returns to this city for the first time in a long time.
In 38 fights, Snipes has been stopped only once. That
chest of Johnny DuPloy, but it's off the face and the lip of Ronaldo Snipes, and a big round for Johnny DuPloy, who received some boos, possibly because of the political situation in his home country, but he has seemed to have turned this crowd around, or at least they're cheering, because it has been a good fight so far.
Snipes looks like he's hurting. As he sits in his corner, he's got the arm up on the rope. That's a sign of a fatigued fighter.
The blood vessels and capillaries much more evident in the mouth region than in the eye area, and that could be a nasty one to close on Ronaldo Snipes. Unusual spot for a wide open cut like that.
Reynaldo,
the referee department took a look at that cut.
Hector Roca continuing to work on Ronaldo Snipes. Jimmy Williams, his stepfather, also in the corner of Ronaldo Snipes. There's water spilled in the corner of Johnny DuPloy. Lou Duva is wiping it up now. That is the delay. The water bomb, the water bucket being spilled to the canvas.
And there's some ice cubes.
Weaver, but that is since healed. Johnny DuPloy 100% physically, showing signs of that tonight.
Good right as he stepped to the side, stepped around and hit him in the back of the head with the right, to the side of the head with the right. Short left by DuPloy was effective there.
As he buckles. Snipes landed a shot to the chin of DuPloy.
DuPloy hurt him with the right, then got a bit anxious with the follow-up shots.
Ronaldo Snipes, like a wounded bull, keeps coming back against Johnny DuPloy. The uppercut's working well for DuPloy. And Snipes looks groggy. His eyes are rolling. He has a nasty cut on his lip. And being propped up by the ropes now as Johnny DuPloy tries to find the wherewithal to possibly finish off Snipes. Working on Johnny DuPloy.
You get the feeling that Snipes is growing tired, sensing that, trying to let go with some big punches to turn this fight around.
Well, Ronaldo Snipes, traditionally a slow starter, but he did came on strong in long. How have you scored it so far, Phil?
I've got DuPloy ahead 49-46 after five rounds.
Look at that jab. Come on. Let's turn it right here.
looks fresh as a daisy as he comes out. The starter, Brown, six. Crowd starting to chant, Johnny, Johnny. Johnny DuPloy, nothing less than a matinee idol in his home country of South Africa. Very marketable fighter. Earns purses of around $50,000. But now he's looking to establish himself in the United States. He fought here once before against Steve Zowski, knocked him out. That was the man who fought George Foreman in his first comeback fight. Well, the rap against Ronaldo Snipes, never being able to win the big fights, to beat a Holmes, to beat a Witherspoon, a Page, or a Biggs. Here's somebody that Ronaldo Snipes never even heard of a year or two ago. And he is in a tussle tonight, no question about it.
Ironically, Snipes does hold the victory over Harry Coetzee, another South African fighter who did hold the heavyweight championship.
And a little bit less zest out of the punches of Johnny DuPloy until that last flurry right there. It looked as though DuPloy was punching in slow motion, and he backs away from that up a good chest in time. Like Ronaldo Snipes is content to the work to the body of Johnny DuPloy. Stages of this fight. So we enter round seven. Johnny DuPloy immediately puts Snipes on the ropes. It's the jab that Lou Duva wants to see DuPloy use more.
Yeah, there's no really good jab that we're seeing from DuPloy.
Snipes is a brawler. DuPloy won't win many points on finesse himself. He has been content to go inside, use his uppercuts. Ronaldo Snipes.
He's looking tired. He's a tired fighter right now.
Johnny DuPloy is 9 years younger than Mr. Snipes, who they call Pops in the sparring ring now. And there goes Ronaldo Snipes. This time, down to the ring because of blows. He went down in the third round, but it was more of a slip.
He was pushed down. DuPloy threw him against the ropes, charged in, hit him with the right hand.
Johnny DuPloy puts his arms up on the ropes like that, leaving his midsection wide open for all those Snipes. Shoving, and that's what Barkman didn't like to see.
He's tired, and he's fighting like a tired fighter. tactics. And that's why points were taken away from Johnny DuFoy, something he cannot afford because
Hector Roca screaming at Dick Barton, and watch the head.
Blood streaming freely out of the mouth of Ronaldo Snipes. Snipes fighting on guts right now, and well, maybe they both are because this one has been non-stop since the second round.
DuPloy, a very tired fighter.
DuPloy is a frustrated fighter right now as well, Phil. And Johnny DuPloy goes down. DuPloy looks like he's quitting.
I think he told the ref he's finished.
DuPloy has had enough. DuPloy's quitting. Ronaldo Snipes has won. Johnny DuPloy quits. Lou Duva can't believe it. Lou Duva is almost coming to blows with Dick Barton. Lou Duva now turns toward Johnny DuPloy. He wants him back out there. I think Ronaldo Snipes, Chris Berger, upset because of the way the referee was reacting to his tactics. But that's only fair because it seems like Snipes was fighting like a tired fighter, as you'd said, and he was doing everything but pulling out a knife on Ronaldo Snipes.
I think he just up and quit. There's no simpler way of saying it. He got fatigued, went down to one knee, more or less, no mas.
Well, a very controversial ending to this fight. In the seventh round, Ronaldo Snipes, who looked like he had used up everything in his repertoire, fighting on instincts and experience, is able to frustrate Johnny DuPloy. Let's take you back now to round seven. As he hugs Jimmy Williams, and there's a look at the replay coming up.
He's not hit, he just drops to his knees. Tells the referee, no mas. Starts walking to the corner.
And I'm finished, he says. Amazing. And the arms stretched high above the head of Ronaldo Snipes, who goes to 31-7-1.
He was winning the fight, and he just gave it up. I had him ahead at the time of the stoppage. 58-56.
Well, that's a interesting development indeed, because Johnny DuPloy was outpointing Ronaldo Snipes. Why did he give up? Was it because of Dick Bartlett not letting DuPloy fight the way he wanted to fight? Or was DuPloy simply frustrated? Well, we'll try to answer those questions.
My mouth sticks out. Oh, you give me my mouth? My mouth, I wanted to pick it up.
Robin Welch now from South Africa is interviewing Johnny
DuPloy. Yeah, of course I do. You want to find him again?
Definitely.
And you will beat him?
Yeah.
Who? It was, look, the guy's over here, fighting over here. The referee became confused. He became confused. He was down. He's looking for his mouthpiece over there. He walked over here. The guy says, where you going? So I'm getting my mouthpiece. He thought he said he quit. He didn't quit. He looked around. He said, that's why I'm give me the mouthpiece. It's down the floor. That's where I went. Johnny was miles ahead. I know that. I know that. And then, I don't know. You want a rematch? Sure.
Well, Robin Welch finds out from Lou Duva that maybe Johnny didn't quit after all. He just was looking for his mouthpiece. Did I hear that?
I don't buy that. I don't buy that.
Decision. How'd you feel about that?
He packed it in.
Come on, John. I can't do nothing about it. I had him in trouble. I was a bit tired. And my mouth got out. And I wanted to pick it up and let him stop the fight. Do you want to fight him again?
I'll definitely fight him again.
You'll beat him?
Definitely, I'll beat him.
Okay, great fight, Johnny. Bad luck. Lou?
South
I think
African
it was a
announcer.
Bad decision, a raw decision. I think the referee was incompetent. He didn't call it the way he supposed to be. He went down. He realized he didn't have his mouthpiece in
the
mouth.
Lou Duva talking.
Hold up, and Johnny, the mouthpiece is over here. He ran over here to pick up the mouthpiece. I'm saying that when he did, I don't know what to do. You beat your fucking ass, you big.
Uh-oh. Bad words now between Lou Duva and Ronaldo Snipes. Snipes
Snipes acts like he wants to go another seven rounds. And look at that cut on the lip of Ronaldo Snipes. It could have cost him the fight. But he hangs in there, and we're still trying to get it sorted out.
I want an interview with him. Please.
All right, Robin Welch from the Mnet television station in South Africa will work his way over with our microphone to Ronaldo Snipes and find out how Snipes saw the outcome of this fight.
All right, Ronaldo. Excuse me. Ronaldo.
Thank you for having me.
Yes, sir.
Great fight. How do you find Johnny DeFloyd?
I find him very strong.
Very strong.
A good fighter.
What do you think of the decision? I know it's in your favor.
What, no damn decision? I beat him on heart.
You want to fight him again? He wants to fight you.
You're damn right I'll fight him again.
You'll find him anywhere.
I'm not going on South Africa. I think you're trying to save him.
No, we're not saying that at all.
Put up the damn money and I'll fight him.
Okay.
Well, Ronaldo Snipes will take on Johnny DeFloyd, give him a rematch, but not in South Africa. We did hear that much. All right, we'll be back to wrap up this fight between Johnny DuPlois and Ronaldo Snipes. It goes to Ronaldo.
423-2350. Call the coach now and get his free winning point spread selection as the Bills take on the Oilers. 1-800-423-2350.
Okay, there you go. Don't look at me when you talk. And I'm going to ask you about what you found out. All right, we are back in a wild scene at the Eagles Club in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. The conclusion of tonight's heavyweight fight between DuPlois and Snipes, a TKO in the seventh round. Now, during the break, Phil Berger had a chance to talk with the official, the referee, Dick Bartman. What did you find out, Phil?
Dick Bartman told me that DuPlois went down without being struck, started walking away, and said the word no. That was it. He took that to mean no mas. That was the end of the fight. Lou Duva says there was a mouthpiece loose. I don't buy that. I thought he just gave it up.
Well, the story we get from the South African corner is that his mouthpiece was indeed on the ground. DuPlois turned away, maybe to pick it up. But I think the pictures tell the story because there was a look of frustration all over the face of Johnny DuPlois. He was brawling with Ronaldo Snipes. When Snipes wouldn't go down, and when Bartman, the referee, kept breaking it up, DuPlois simply said, no mas.
He became fatigued about a round or two earlier and was fighting like a fighter who was just losing strength. He turned it into a roughhouse bout in the last round, and when push came to shove, I think he just bagged it.
Well, let's take another look at the action there in the seventh round. I don't think we have seen the end of Johnny DuPlois, but you cannot go around quitting fights.
No, he's a project. He's got potential.
Now watch the face of Johnny DuPlois right here, frustrated. He, a sign of resignation. He lifts his hands and says, finished, in whatever language, Afrikaans or English.
That doesn't look anything like mouthpiece.
All right, so we hope you've enjoyed the action tonight. It's been a wild one. And Ricky Parkey losing to Alfonso Ratliff for the USBA Cruiserweight title. And in seven rounds, it was Ronaldo Snipes stopping Johnny DuPlois. We'll see DuPlois again for Ronaldo Snipes. What a way to close out his career. He'll fight again for the money, but it's a good way to wind things up for the man they call Ronaldo Mr. Snipes.
Yeah, this will give him a chance for some more big money fights. I mean, he's beaten an opponent who's a serious contender. Whether Johnny DuPlois can rally from this, I don't know. It's a morally shattering.